So hello students. So in the last class we have completed the convolution, that is when a input signal is given and the system response HN is given, then convolution is the mathematical tool in linear time invariant system, that is LTI system, in time domain to calculate the response of the system. This is another concept which is like your convolution. Here we will study about correlation of two sequences. It has made many application. So it is used to compare between the two signals. So student, you must not be confused about convolution and correlation. Correlation means comparison between two signals. What you will compare, that you will see. Correlation means it is used to compare between two signals, comparing the similarity between two signal, that we will study about in correlation. It has many application, that is in radar and sonar, that you are studying in advanced communication, where we are sending a electromagnetic wave and from the target the wave is reflected back, and then we are comparing and finding the range of the target, velocity at which it is approaches, that will determine. So radar and sonar, we are comparing between the original signal and the reflected signal. So that technical term is known as your correlation. It has also many application in image processing, to compare between the two image. So correlation stands for comparing between two signals. So let us study about the definition of the correlation and types of correlation. So as we have discussed, so correlation is to measure or to compare between the two signals. So what we are comparing? We are comparing the similarity between the two signals. And what is the outcome? We are where we are using this application. We are particularly using this in radar, sonar, and in various types of image processing and in control systems. In control system, we have studying that the output signal through feedback we are comparing with the input signal. So similarly, in order to get the desired output. Similarly, in case of radar and sonar, we are comparing the reflected signal with the original electromagnetic waves that we have sent, in order to find the range of the target, or to find the velocity of the target, or to find the position of the target. So that we have written here the definition. Correlation is the measure of degree to which the two signals are similar. Correlation is a measure of degree to which the two signals are similar. So it is of two types, depending on the correlation, what type of correlation they have, that is cross correlation and autocorrelation. So let us study about one by one. First we will study about cross correlation and its properties, then we will study about autocorrelation. So first of all, we'll study about the cross correlation. So cross correlation means we are performing the correlation, that is, we are comparing between two different signal. We are comparing between two different signal. So first one is your, suppose, xn, and another signal is yn, and you need to perform the cross correlation. Then what is the definition? See, cross correlation, it can be denoted as R. So R is cross correlation between two different signal. So I am writing here x and y, R x y l is equal to summation of n is equal to minus infinity xn y of n minus l. So here l is the shift or lag parameter. So we have a signal xn and we have a delayed version y of n minus l. So y, you are just delaying or right shifting, that we have studied in shifting operation, and then we perform the cross correlation. It is just like your convolution. It is just like your convolution. So but it is quite different. In convolution, we can see that x of k, h of n minus k, but here we can see x of n, y of n minus k, but here it is y of n minus l, that is, l is your shift or lag parameter. But how we are mathematically found? So you can use the definition for infinite duration sequence, but for finite duration sequence, you can just perform, replace x of n and x of by x of l and y of n by y of minus l. So y of minus l means you are time reversing. So one signal is xl, that is convolved with another signal's time reversal. So first of all, we have to find, suppose yn is a signal is given, just time reversal that signal and perform the convolution, we will get the cross correlation. And cross correlation here denoted by R x y l. X y means two different signal. So it is the cross correlation between a pair of signal xn and yn is given by, this is the definition, and this is the mathematical operation for finite duration sequence. That is how you can find the cross correlation. Then we will study about autocorrelation. So next is autocorrelation. So autocorrelation, we perform correlation of a signal xn with itself. That means here we are not using another signal, just like in cross correlation we have two different signal, but here we are performing correlation with itself. That means in radar, for example, you are sending a signal at time instant, particular time instant, then we are receiving the echo signal at a different time instant, but the same signal we are receiving. So in that case, when you perform the comparing the two, autocorrelation means performing the comparison between the signal with itself. That means one is the signal xn itself and another is xn delayed with some time version. That means you are receiving some echo signal after some time delay, and now we are performing comparison. So autocorrelation means, the name itself says autocorrelation. Auto stands for the, you are making the comparison between the signal, between two signal xn with some time delay, that is xn with itself. Itself means not xn and xn. Suppose, for example, a signal xn is given, which is suppose starting from time 0, then you are comparing same signal at some different time instant. So that is known as your auto correlation. So it has various property. So one property which is very, very important, that will write auto correlation at origin, auto correlation at origin, that means R x x 0, when you put l is equal to 0 in the definition, what you will find? Summation of n is equal to minus infinity infinity xn square. So autocorrelation at origin gives the energy of the signal. So always remember, this is very, very important. Autocorrelation at origin gives the energy of the signal, energy or power of the signal. So autocorrelation at origin, when you put l is equal to 0, you will find in the definition, if you put l is equal to 0, you will find xn and xn, and xn square always going to give you summation of n is equal to minus infinity infinity square of xn, that will give you the energy of the signal. So this is very, very important. So student, please pay attention to this. So cross correlation means we are comparing two different signal. Autocorrelation means we are comparing the same signal with some time delay version with itself. That is, xn and x of n minus l we are comparing. Xn and x of n minus l. So that's why I have written here r xx. So mathematically, how to find? So this is the definition, and another method for finding autocorrelation is r x x l is equal to nothing but x of l convolution with x of minus l. So this is another definition for another method for calculating autocorrelation. So thank you. In the next class, we will solve some problem autocorrelation and start Z transform. Thank you.